What do you do if people whine? What do you do if they complain and carry on? Do you ever complain and carry on? I've listened to it all day today because it's freezing today. It hasn't been above zero today. The sun's been out and there's snow in the mountains, but it's really cold. And that's what I've been hearing all day. Rowie, it's so cold. And other places in the country and in the world, I've been hearing, Rowie, it's so hot. Rowie, it's so raining. And people whinge and whine about the weather a lot, don't they? Have we noticed that people whinge and whine a fair bit? One of my favourite responses to whining, complaining and whinging usually goes like this. Would you like some cheese with that wine? Just to make it fun. And here's a great question. What do we whine about and why do we whine? Hey, puppy dogs! My puppy dogs don't whine. If they want to go out, they bark. If they want attention, they bark. I'm not sure that that's whining. I just think that that's dogs being dogs. And I would hate to think that humans are part of our being a human is to whine, whinge, and complain. Because here's a great question. Do people care if you whinge, whine, and complain? And I'll rephrase the question. If you ask somebody, how are you? And they tell you, I'm sick, I'm tired, I've got a headache, I've got a sore toe, I'm busy, I'm stressed, I've had a bad day, my life is pretty crap. Do you love listening to that stuff? Do you, even if it's somebody that you really love, wouldn't it be nice to hear, yes, I've got a stack of stuff going on in my life right now, I've got a stack of challenges going on, but I'm a solution finder, I'm a challenge overcomer. Versus, oh, I've got all these terrible things going on in my life. And I've got to ask the question, because I deal with it every day, why do we tell other people the crap that's going on into our life, going on in our life? Why do we think that other people want to help us even? And even more importantly, why do we think that they can? And I always use the example, if I've got a sore body, why would I talk to the bus driver about it? If I've got a broken car, I'm not going to talk to my lawyer. If I need to build a house, I'm not going to talk to a landscape gardener. If I need something done, let's find the expert to do it. And if I've got a challenge or a problem, or I want to whinge, whine, moan, and complain about something, how about we go to the person that can find the solution rather than just dump our rubbish onto people? And I think it's a really important question because I don't know about you, but I get dumped on a lot and it doesn't affect me because I just go, well, I'm glad my life's not like that, and I always turn it into a positive. But I always feel a bit sad for the people that are whinging and moaning and complaining at me because they're hearing it again. If you've got a sore foot and everybody you see during the day, you say, yeah, I've got a sore foot, I've got a sore foot, I've got a sore foot, I've got a sore foot. By the end of the day, your foot's going to be bloody sore because you've told so many people about it. And your brain, of course, does exactly what you tell it to do. Isn't that exciting? So what if the exciting part of that was you don't tell yourself, I'm sick, I'm tired, I'm fat, I've had a bad day. How about I'm amazing, I'm a solution finder, I'm positive, I'm optimistic, I love my life, I love everything that happens to me because I can learn and grow from it, rather than whinge, moan and complain. And what a reputation. Do you want to have the reputation of being a whiner, a whinger, a complainer, somebody who's always got a challenge versus somebody who never talks about their challenges and you just help other people overcome theirs? Do you want to be the person that whinges, moans and complains, or you're the person that people come to find a solution because they go, that person never whinges, moans and complains. They're always the person that is optimistic. They are a solution finder. They're a positive person. And I know that if I ask for help, they'll be able to help me out. I'll go a step further than that. Wouldn't the best place to find a helping hand be at the end of your own arm? And as I always ask, if you do have to ask somebody else for help, is it more likely that they want to help you if you've done as much as you possibly can on your own? There's always people that will help you. There's always lovely people in the world. I get that. But is it possible that they're more likely to respect you and more likely to want to help you if you've done as much as you possibly can on your own? So I've got this challenge. I've done everything. These are the big, long list of things that I've done on my own. The rest of this I can't figure out by myself. Could you please brainstorm with me to help me find a solution, not whinge, moan and complain about the problem? Please help me find a solution, and let's go to the people that can help us with the solution. So if you're going to build a house, don't go to the car mechanic, and if you've got a broken car, don't go to the doctor. Find the person that can help you with the solution. And again, I'll go one step further than that. If you're asking for professional advice from a doctor, from a lawyer, from a mechanic, from a builder, would it be a really good idea to book an appointment and pay for that appointment. Now, the person might not ask you to pay, but wouldn't it be really respectful to offer rather than just, I've got this problem, whinge, moan and complain, please can you help me? How about, I've got a challenge, I need a solution, you're the best person to help me find the solution because you're the expert in this area. What will it be, what will the dollar investment be for me to invest time with you to help me find a solution? And I think that could be a respectful way to do things. I'll reverse that. Have we become a disrespectful world where every time you meet somebody or you haven't seen your friends for a long time or you haven't seen your family for a little while and they say, how are you? And you go, oh, not too bad. I've got a headache on a sore foot. I'm really tired. I'm really stressed. I'm not sure that any of us want to hear that. And I think we love it when somebody says, yes, I've got some challenges going on in my life, but I'm a challenge overcomer. Wouldn't it be great to have that reputation? So if you're whinging, moaning and complaining, how about have some cheese with that wine? And if you don't want a reputation as a whinger, moaner, complainer and a whiner, how about don't whinge, moan, complain and whine? That could be a good idea. Live your life to the max without any whinging, moaning, complaining and whining. What a great idea. Super duper doo, how are you? I'm never going to tell you I've had a bad day because I'd never do that. Woohoo!